Electrophilic addition. Here we look at the electrophilic addition reaction involving ethene and bromine. That's bromine Br2, a homonuclear diatomic molecule that is nonpolar. There's the ethene molecule with its carbon-carbon double bond made up of a sigma and pi bond. And we have a region there between the two carbon atoms with four electrons concentrated, described as an area of high electron density. And there is our bromine molecule, Br2. Why do we have these delta plus, delta minus symbols? They represent a molecule that has a dipole. Let me explain why. There are the two electrons shared between the two bromine atoms, and normally, given that bromine is a homonuclear diatomic molecule, the electrons will be evenly shared and spend their time around both bromine atoms equally. You might like to pause and look at the change in electronegativity from one element to another, but in this case, since the two atoms are the same, normally the electrons would spend their time equally around both atoms. But look what happens. This region of high electron density will tend to repel the electrons on the upper side of the bromine atom. One region of electron density repelling another. Now, as a result, the electrons will tend to spend their time more around the lower bromine atom. And this will create what is known as a dipole. The lower bromine atom will have a slightly greater share of the bonding pair of electrons and will be assigned a delta minus charge, delta indicating a small charge. The upper bromine has a slight deficiency in electrons, less than its fair share, and is assigned a delta positive charge. We need to propose this idea in order to suggest why the Br2 molecule should be eventually attracted in and react with the ethene molecule. So the ethene molecule initially polarizes the Br2 molecule, creating a delta plus delta minus end, and then the delta plus end is attracted in. So the Br2 molecule is said to be a dipole, literally two poles, opposite ends, a delta plus at the top there and a delta minus at the bottom. Watch now how the carbon-carbon double bond breaks, specifically the pi bond. That carbon on the right-hand side will lose out as this happens. It will lose the electron that contributed to the pi bond. Watch how those two electrons of the pi bond now come around and are used instead to form a bond with that upper bromine atom, the one that had the delta plus charge on it. The right-hand carbon has a positive charge now because, as I said, it lost the electron that had contributed to the pi bond. We see there that carbocation intermediate coming in from the left there, and below it there's the bromide ion, Br minus, minus charge because it got an extra electron when the bond broke. And the lone pair, that's the two electrons that had formed the Br-Br bond. That carbocation, which lost an electron when the pi bond broke, it attracts in the bromide ion now. Watch how the lone pair in the bromide ion is now used to form a bond between it and the carbon. So the bromine is agreeing to share its pair of electrons. The positive charge in the carbon has gone because that carbon, in gaining a share in a pair of electrons, that lone pair on the bromine is effectively up an electron and has lost its positive charge. And conversely, the bromine has lost its negative charge, that bromide ion, because in agreeing to share that lone pair of electrons with the carbon, it's effectively down an electron and is therefore back to a neutral state. So the mechanism has two steps. The first step is the slow rate determining step. Notice how we use curly arrows to show the movement of those pairs of electrons, helping to explain the mechanism. We should also show the delta plus and delta minus charges, of course. And you need to be able to show these delta plus, delta minus charges, the curly arrows, and the structure of the intermediate in order to get full marks for presenting any mechanism. Let's put the delta plus, delta minus there on the Br2 that gets the reaction up and running. There we are. We've got the structure of the intermediate, the carbocation. We see how the lone pair on the Br- is shared. And we should put the intermediate in square brackets. And the product is 1,2-dibromoethane.